Welcome to session 2020-21. My dear students and respected parents, Team Literans have come up with innovative ideas to keep the learnings on amidst this pandemic of COVID-19. It's a sincere request to parents, please utilize this lockdown period to give memories to your child which they will cherish for life. We will help them to become citizens for tomorrow's world through your life skills and our efforts to keep their learning a continuous process. I congratulate all the students for their wonderful results in Standard 7 and wish them all the best for the upcoming class. So children, now today we will start Chapter 1 for your science in Standard 8. Crop production and management. It is one of the most important chapters as you move from class 8 to class 9 and finally to your class 10. It will become a basis for your class 10. Many elementary questions or value added questions you can utilize from this chapter. So first we move on to what is the importance of crop production and management. Crop production is one of the earliest learned sciences by the human race. Why? Because it satisfies the basic needs of human race, that is food. And gradually we will learn that there are many other things which we need through this crop production and management. So crop production is a very early gained art of human race. The science of crop production and its management gives us food, enough food to meet the demands of growing human race. We all need food to remain alive, to get energy, to do all the work, to live healthy, disease-free life and live a happy life. Like these days, you need a well-balanced nutritive diet to keep yourself healthy and free of this infection. Hence, crop production and management is the most important occupation all over the world. If you see that it is one of the common occupation and major occupation for all the countries. Why? Because it provides food to its population. It provides clothes to its population. It provides medicine to its population. And many other things which we will see later in the chapter. Now we come to the term, what is agriculture and what is crop? Trust me children, these are two very simple terms and very commonly asked question. Define agriculture or what do you mean by a crop? And trust me, these are very easy for you and you have a privilege over the children of Delhi and Mumbai that you very commonly see the crop, you commonly see the agriculture around you. And we will move to the chapter further. You will find that this many things related with this chapter you can very easily find around yourself. So my first question is, what is meant by the term crop? Okay. If you cannot define, then just try to answer the small questions which I am going to ask. How many types of plants are grown in a crop? Just look around and tell. You can very easily find the fields around you and you can see the crops growing. So how many types? Yes, like if you see a nearby field in your house through your windows even, you will see that how many types of crops are there. If there is only wheat, if there is only rice, if there is only mustard, or there is only lentil, whatever it is. Yes, the type of plant in a crop is only one. Now think how many plants are there in that field. Can you count? The number of plants in a crop is uncountable. If you want to utilize the time of lockdown, you can go and just count. but practically it is uncountable. Now the next thing is, what is the purpose of this plantation? Rice is planted for food, wheat is planted for food. So there are very many purposes for which the crop plantation is done. So in one line you can say it, to meet various demands of human population. So now you just try to define what a crop is. When the same type of plants is grown on a large scale for food, clothing, medicine, etc. in one place, they are called as crops. Now, what is meant by agriculture? To understand the concept of agriculture, I want to know something from you all. Will the crops alone satisfy all the needs of humans? Now my question is, like, if we only concentrate on the plants, so can we satisfy all the needs of humans? No, we cannot. Take for example food only. We take many products from animal also. Can you name a few? That means we have to rear the animals also. So it is a concept where we have to grow the crops and rear the animals also. Now tell me, why do we need only food? Or do we need only food from these plants and animals? What else we need from these plants and animals? Now if you recall the chapter Fiber to Fabric of your classes 6 and 7, you will come to list many other needs which we need from the plants. Yes, apart from food, these are clothes. Now here I have a question for you, which I am not going to answer. Now here I want you all to make a list of at least 5 such things apart from clothes and food. I repeat, make a list of at least 5 such things apart from clothes and food. I will come up to this question later again. So students, just try to define what agriculture is. The science or practice of growing plants and rearing animals for food, clothing and other useful products is known as agriculture. Very good. Oh, this is me over there and I am saying something. That means I am again going to ask a question. Now children, look at this map. What can you see from the map shown over here? You can notice that there are many different colors. First thing which you can notice. Now tell me, what are those colors? Green, pink, yellow, orange. Okay. Now look at the table given on the right hand side of the map. What these colors are corresponding to different crops. Like green is corresponding to chickpea, blue is corresponding to coconut. So what do you infer when you look at this map? Look at the map shown alongside carefully and try to say something about the agriculture in India. We can see that in each state there are different specific types of crops which can grow there. Like if you see your state of Bihar only, you won't see all the colors over there. Predominantly you are seeing there chickpea and rice. If you see the states of UP, you will see wheat over there. If you see in the Maharashtra and Karnataka area, you will find millets and corn and other plantations. And if we go to the northeastern side, you will find written tea over there. That is corresponding to tea plantation. So each state has a different type of crop. It is not that each state or each place can give whatever crop you want, they will give you. No. So here, what do we infer that? There are certain factors which affect the agriculture in India. So what are these factors which affect the agriculture in India? Can you name some factors? You can pause the video and go back to the map and try to think, try to observe what these factors are. Yes, you got it. It's that easy. Our country is a vast and diverse domain. We have hot climates, dry climates, humid climates, and cold climates also. We have black soil, red soil, yellow soil, and many other factors are there. Thus, we can say that it is because of following factors that India can produce varieties of crops. Or factors affecting agriculture in India are, number one, humidity of a place. Number two, temperature of a place. Number three, rainfall type of a region. And the most important one, type of soil of a particular region. So just jot down these. What are the factors affecting agriculture in India? Number one, humidity of a place. Number two, temperature of a place. Number three, rainfall type of a region. Number four, type of soil of a particular region. Okay. Now, based on these factors, we have divided crops into two broad categories. On the basis of season, India experiences different seasons. This is the summer season going on. After a few months, we will have monsoon. Then we will have winter. And in different season, we get different types of crops. And there are the crops based on their uses also. We can classify the crops based on their uses also. So based on the season, there are three types of crops. I know you have read about two, but there is one more type of crop. So based on the season, how many types of crops are there? Three types. Kharif crop, Rabi crop, and Zaid crops. What are they? Kharif crop, Rabi crop, and Zaid crop. And based on the uses, crops can be classified into two types, food crops and cash crops. So we will see in details what are these different types of crops. So crops can be classified either based on the season into three types or based on the uses into two types. Types of crops on the basis of season are Kharif crop, Zaid crop, Rabi crop. Based on the uses, food crop, cash crop. Very good. So classification of crops based on season in which they grow are Kharif crop, which are the monsoon crops. These are planted in June and harvested in October. You can see the example, rice, cotton, maize, groundnut. And it's very easy for you to remember because you are seeing them. That in the season of monsoon, you see these rice fields, paddy fields, and just before the Diwali, they are harvested. Then we have Rabi crops, which are also known as winter crops, which are planted in the month of November and harvested in the April, near about Holi. So Rabi crops, they are planted in the November after the harvesting of Kharif crop has been done. These are wheat, pea, barley, gram. So if you remember that Kharif crops are the monsoon crops, you can easily tell their examples. If you remember, rabi crops are winter crops. You can easily tell their examples also. So major question you get there is, what is the difference between kharif crop and rabi crop? Or a list of crops is given and you have to classify them into rabi crop and kharif crop. Now in between the kharif crop and rabi crop, we have zaid crops, which are also called as summer crops, like cucumber, watermelon, muskmelon. These are all zaid crops, means they are planted in the month of March, somewhere in between the kharif and the rabi crop. When the rabi crop is harvested and we are still waiting for the fields to plant the kharif, we plant these zaid crops. So it is a short period cropping. Its duration is very short and it gives a good amount of financial backup to the farmers. In between the rabi crop and kharif crop, there is the zaid crops. So starting like in the month near about Holi, the rabi is harvested. Now immediately we cannot do the cropping of kharif. So there we do the zaid crops, and these are cucumber, muskmelon, watermelon. These things are there, summer crops. They have a very short cropping period, planted in the month of March and harvested in the June. And once they are harvested, we do the cropping of kharif crops. So that is very important. Different types of crops based on the season. You have various questions based on it. What is kharif crop? Give their example. What is rabi crop? Give their example. What is zaid crop? Give their example. Or you get the list of crops and you have to classify them as kharif, zaid and rabi. Very easy and very important question. Now, types of crops based on their uses. On the basis of uses, crops are of two types. Cash crop. A cash crop is an agricultural crop which is grown for sale to return a profit. The main motive is to get a profit. It may not be an essential demand of human race. That you have to note. It is a cash crop is not an essential demand for the human race. The very common thing is tobacco, plantation of tobacco. It's a cash crop. And the next type of crop is food crop. A food crop is an agricultural crop which is grown for human consumption. The main motive is for food crop is to provide food like wheat, rice, lentil. So based on the uses, crops can be of two types, food crops and cash crops. Cash crops include cotton, sugarcane, tobacco, oil seeds. Food crops are wheat, rice, maize, barley, gram, which are providing food. So now this slide give you the difference between kharif crop and rabi crop, cash crop and food crop. You will write down these points. And you will learn these points, because I'm saying it again, children, it is an important question for your exams. Kharif crops are shown on the onset of monsoon. Rabi crops are shown on the onset of winter season. Kharif crop require lot of water. Rabi crop require moderate water. Examples of kharif crops are rice, maize, jowar, bajra. Examples of rabi crops are wheat, barley, peas, gram, etc. Then kharif crops are harvested in winter. Rabi crops are harvested in summer. Then difference between cash crop and food crop? Yes, cash crop refers to the crop used for commercial purposes. Food crop refers to the crop that are edible. Cash crop is grown for the purpose of profit. Food crop can be used for human consumption. Cash crops are grown for selling on a large scale. Food crops are used by the farmer's family only, or they can be used for only the farmer family, and they can be used for providing to a human population also. Example of cash crop are tea and coffee. Example of food crop is wheat and rice. So that is the end for today's part, and very soon I will come up with the part 2 also, maybe the next day. And also I will be uploading the worksheet for checkpoint and milestone 1. You will check the uploaded worksheet in the assignments and worksheet as in the website of the school. Please go through that and solve your queries regarding the questions given in your book of checkpoint and milestone. Have a good day.